Hey everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to go over 5 Photoshop hacks or tricks to speed up your workflow in 2018. So let's go ahead and get started. Number one is the Quick Mask tool for selections. So you can add to a selection that already exists. I'm going to go ahead and make a new layer. So I'll use my rectangular marquee tool to draw just a thicker rectangle here. And now I'll hit Q for Quick Mask, and you can also click this button down here to get to your Quick Mask. I'm going to change this so it'll be opposite of this. So I'm going to hit Q again and then double click it, and we'll say selected areas. So now we have the selection that we want. Now the red part is the selection. So I can hit my E tool, which is the eraser, holding Control and Alt. I'll resize my brush. And then I'll just erase part of the image here, part of the red stuff, and that's my selection. So this is sort of like painting a selection or erasing a selection. So I'm just going to erase all of the stuff where it's covering the shells. Oh, also, you'll want to have black and white set as your foreground and background. Okay, I'm going to zoom out here. And now I'll hit Q again, and you can see the selection. I have a new layer created, so I'm going to go ahead and hit Option Delete to fill with my foreground color, which is black. So as you can see, yeah, it's not perfect. I'm doing this pretty quick, but that's how you can quickly make a selection with the Quick Mask. You can paint your selection that way. I'll knock this down to about 50. Okay, so then in this case, I would maybe put some text over here, you know, something like that. All right, I'm going to hide this and do another quick thing with this. I'm going to hit B for the brush tool, and then I'll hit Q for quick selection. And now I'll just paint this part right here. I'll hit Q again to get off of the quick selection, turn it back into a selection. And now I can hit Command J to jump the pixels. So we can move this other one around now. We can position it differently by clicking Command T or Control T. All right, so that is the Quick Mask tool for selections. Just think of it as painting a selection on instead of using the lasso tool to do your selection. And to get in and out of that is Q. And you would use your brush and the eraser tool, which are here and here. All right, number two, adding a color gradient to a photo in the layer above. So I'm gonna grab this photo right here. And let's say I wanted to put some text right down here. That can be a problem because it's pretty busy. You might be able to do it right down at the bottom, but if you wanted a lot of text, that would be a problem. So in this case, I would create a new layer. And I would fill it with black. If you don't have black and white, you can just hit the letter D and it will change your colors here to black foreground and white outline. I'm gonna fill this entire layer with black. So Option Delete to fill with the foreground color. And now I'm gonna make a layer mask. I'll just put that right there. And then I'll come up to the gradient tool. And I'll draw a gradient. And now we have a gradient over the bottom. Makes it a lot better for text. Let me just type something. Okay, so that just really darkens the bottom up, and you can see how much the text pops off of there now that we've changed and added that background gradient. Now, you can always bump this down a little bit. It's pretty drastic right now, so I'm gonna put it at 70%. Maybe we'll put it up at 90, 80. 80, I think, is good. So that is my second tip, adding a color gradient in the layer above the photo layer. For my third tip, we're going to copy a shape in from Illustrator to use as a mask. I'm going to create a new layer, and then with my brush tool, I'm just going to kind of draw some scribble lines. And now we'll head over to Illustrator. And here in Illustrator, we're going to go to the shape tool, and we'll do a star. And I'm gonna hold Shift and Alt to keep the star the normal shape instead of this shape. If you hold Alt, it will change it to the actual star. So we'll just use that star. I'm going to copy it, and then we'll head back over to Photoshop and paste it in as a smart object. I almost always use smart object. It really, in this case, will work for almost any of these. Doesn't really matter, but I like smart objects, so we'll just do that. And there it is. I'm going to kind of position it over some of the scribbles and hit return. And then I'm going to command click that layer, just on the picture part of the layer, or you can also control click if you're on a PC. So now we have a selection where that layer is. Now click on the layer with the scribbles, layer, layer mask, and reveal selection. And now we can just go ahead and throw our vector smart object away, and that reveals the little scribble behind there. Now, if you want to move your scribble around, you can unlink the mask like this. Just click on that little shape in the middle there. And make sure you're clicked on this part of the layer. And then you can move this around back behind there. That looks about good. Okay, and we will, I like to link them up again. That's just so that this will move with the shape. So now if we move the layer, it'll all move together. All right, for number four, I want to show you how to paint with a pattern. So I brought up this glittery image, and what we'll do is we will select all, Command A or Control A with a PC. Make sure you are on the glitter layer, or you can also just draw a marquee around the section you want. It's really hard to see my marquee there, sorry about that, but I'm just going to select everything, Command A. And we'll go up here to Edit, Define Pattern. Okay, and you can name it whatever you want, doesn't really matter. Hit S, and that'll bring you to the clone stamp tool. Now underneath there is the pattern stamp tool. So you can hit Shift S to get to that, or you can just choose it like I did. Now I'm going to hide the purple layer. I already have a background layer here. So now we can come up here and choose our most recent pattern. You do have to come up here and choose it, but now you can draw with that. It gives very nice sparklies. And if you have a tablet like I do, it'll be pressure sensitive. All right, so that's how to paint with a pattern. Can't be on the brush to do this. You have to be on the pattern stamp tool. That's one thing I always forget, and I always go over to my brush tool and it doesn't work. Number five is just something that you should probably know if you're working with Photoshop a lot, is how to get rid of swatches. And I don't mean to select them one by one and throw them away. That is the old way of doing it. There's a much faster way right now. I like to keep only the swatches in my color palette. So I'm gonna come up here and do Preset Manager. And here we have all the swatches we want. And I only want these four colors. So I'm going to select all of these holding Shift. We'll delete those. And then I'm going to click once, hold Shift, and then click the last one and delete those. And now we only have the four in my color palette, which is what I want. It's awesome. So now I don't have to fight the swatch palette as much as I used to. I felt like I was always trying to get rid of swatches. So those are my five Photoshop hacks or tricks that really speed up my own workflow, and I hope they really work for you too. Now, if you like this video, please click on the like button, and I will see you next Thursday. Thank you, everyone.